The original control chart invented by Walter Schuchert was the Xbar and R chart, and that depends on what we call rational subgroups of data. Now, frequently Xbar and R charts are done wrong, and the most common failure is failure to form rational subgroups. So these five data right here, 100.6, 103.6, 97.1, 102.3, and 104.7 need to be a rational subgroup. Well, what's a rational subgroup? That's a set of items that were produced under conditions that are as nearly identical as possible. So these may be five sequential items that came off one machine. What we're going to plot is the average. That'll be the X bar. Okay, that's the average of these five data. And the lower chart will be the range chart, which will simply be the largest of these minus the smallest. That's 7.62. Now, what I've done for you is I've opened up QuikSigma, and under baseline and capability, which happens to include the behavior charts, I've opened up the X bar and R chart. And I've taken this first rational subgroup here, and I've placed it in the column here, and I've indicated that it's subgroup number one. Now, alternatively, if I want, I can leave this column blank and just click here and tell it that my subgroups are all size 5. And by the way, you may wonder, does it have to be 5? No, it doesn't. 2, 3, 4, 5, up to possibly as many as 10. Depends on what you want to do. Now, the next thing that I will do after I open that back up is I will bring this next subgroup over, and maybe that's a set of samples that were taken an hour later. And then I'll take the third one and the fourth, and I'll start to fill out the column over here. So I'll do that and then come back and show you the result. Okay, what I've done is I've transferred over all 25 subgroups that were generated in the random number generator. And you can see that here. I have checked the four Western Electric rules and I've clicked Calculate. So that produces my chart. And I look at my subgroup means here, and they're nice and stable and predictable. Well, that's kind of what you get when you get your data out of a random number generator. And below here, the ranges, we've got a couple of points that are showing rule violations. You will occasionally get a false positive. So every time you get a rule violation doesn't necessarily mean there's a problem. It just means you ought to look and see if there is a problem. So there you have X bar and R charts. The key is rational subgroups. The reward is these are more sensitive than INMR charts. They're a little harder to do, but they give a better result.